Hello and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial. I'm Andre from PSD Box, and today I will show you how to create this really weird manipulation in Photoshop. It's an effect that is very easy to create, and I will show you how I did it. I just used some layer masks and some brushes, and let me show you the original image, which is this. So I hope you will like this tutorial, and let's get started. So to start making this manipulation, you first have to download this stock image. I downloaded it from pixabay.com. On the video description, you will have the link to that, to this file. And also on my website, you will have the links to the brushes. These birds, these flying birds, are actually some brushes that I made. And let me group everything here and start over again. Let's drag this under my image and delete this layer mask and also delete this effect. So this is the image that I started working with. As you can see, it's a bit dark. So the first thing that I did is I created some levels just to bring a bit of light back on the image. So I moved this highlight slider because you can see we have this gap here, which means there's no highlights on the image, and maybe mid-tones a bit, and maybe darken the shadows like that. So these are the settings that I have: 81.34 and 205. Just make the image a bit more bright. And the next thing is to start masking. And it's pretty easy because, as you can see, these dark spots of the giraffe skin are separated by this brighter tone. So that is really easy to mask. So what we do is select this layer, get this magic wand tool, and these are the settings that I used: 3x3 average and tolerance of 27, and check the contiguous, which is very important. Otherwise, you will select all similar area, which is not what we want. I want to select the areas myself. Let's leave it like that, and uncheck sample all layers. And all you need to do is just click on the areas there, but you can see it's not selecting the entire area. So I'll just zoom in a bit and press and hold the shift key, and you can see how that plus appears under this tool here, and also here on the top toolbar, which means you can add areas to your selection as long as you keep the shift key pressed, and then just move around and just a couple of clicks here and there to select some of the areas here. This one as well. This one. So just select some of the spots here, which will be our empty spots around this, like that. And now press and hold the Alt key and click the layer mask icon to create an inverted layer mask and just hide these spots here. What I want to do now is just use the brush tool. Let's use a normal brush to recover these areas here, because I don't want to hide these ones. Like that. I just wanted these areas to be empty. Okay, so now I want to refine this layer mask. So I'll right click on it and choose Refine Mask. If you don't have this option — I'm using Photoshop CC, but if you don't have this Refine Mask option, all you need to do is control click the layer mask to load the selection, and then select any selection tool, any marquee tool, and you'll hit this. You will see this button here appearing, which says Refine Edge. And also, if you right click, I think you will find this. Yeah, Refine Edge right here. Okay, so let's refine this mask. And here the settings that I have are feather 2 pixels, contrast 40%, and shift edge minus 15%. So these are the settings that I have. Do not increase the smoothness, because you will start to create smoother corners, which is not what we want. So if the feather is too high, lower it to 1 pixel and see what happens. Between 1 and 2 for this canvas size works, so I'll leave it like that. And I'll change the output to layer mask. which will update my layer mask with this new refine edge on it. So let's click OK. And okay, we have the holes here. Now all we need to do is recreate the sky behind this to make it look like this are actually holes through the giraffe's neck. And that's pretty easy because we have a fairly simple sky here. So what I will do is create a layer beneath my giraffe skin, a giraffe layer, and I'll name it sky. Actually, let me delete the whole thing here, this groups, which I will not need. Okay, and what I will do now is select the lasso tool, and I will get a piece of sky from here. I will get one of the parts here where you can see we have some of these clouds here, just a big chunk like that. Right click and choose, make sure first you select the giraffe layer, right click on it and choose create layer via copy. And now I'll drag this, I'll copy it, Control C, because I already have this layer here. And with Control Command V, I'll paste it. And now I can move this around. If you press Control Command T, you can see the boundaries of this, so you can see where you place it. And I'll leave it right there. So now this little cloud here has like a, like it's moving well across there. So now we have the sky in place. If you want, you can soften it. You can see I have on the lasso tool, I have a feather of 10 pixels. But if the edge is too hard, if you see, I don't see any transition here. But if you see it, just use a layer mask and use a soft brush to blend the edges. Now let's add those birds there. I have some brushes that I made on resources.psdbox.com. You'll find this brush pack, which is this one. And I use this pack along with the animals pack here I use some of the flying birds around here to add the birds here. So this is how I did it. I created a new layer and let's name this birds one and get the brush tool. And here are all the brushes that I have. And let's get this one, for example. And what I did is I sampled a color from one of these dark spots, for example, this one. And then I opened the brushes panel and I activated shape dynamics. And here I increased the size jitter here and maybe the angle a bit and the roughness, the roundness as well, just a bit. And here, all you need to do now is, well, first I have to make the brush a little smaller, about, let's say, 60 pixels. And just start clicking here and there to add a few birds. These ones are too close together. One there, one there, and maybe one there. And then change the brush, use another one, and do the same, just to add some variation. Maybe some angle as well and some roundness. And again, make the brush a bit smaller because it's too big, about 60. And again, a few clicks here and there like that. What I wanted is to create a sort of shape like this. Let me get the brush tool use a different brush. I wanted to create a shape like this, like they're all starting from here and then they start to fade off as you're going away to the right. Okay, so that's what I'm trying to do. Let's get this other brush again, like that. And now let's get another one. So it takes a bit of time to make this birds. If you want to use the same one, the same brush, it will look very fake. So try to avoid that. Even now I'm using too many copies of the same brush, but for this tutorial, just to show you the effect that I created. And then you can use one of the other brushes here that have multiple birds on it. So, but for that, I'll create a new layer. So I'll name this Birds 2. And I'll use a smaller brush and just make it smaller and click here once. And then maybe get another brush like this one and add a flying bird there, and one there. Okay, now that we have the birds, what I would like to do is start filling part of this with some smaller birds. So what I will do is select the layer mask, control click it, and I have to invert it because right now I'm selecting the outer edges, not the inner edge. And I'll go to select inverse right here, and I'll use some smaller brushes. Well, actually what you can do is create a layer below the giraffe layer and name it birds 3 and just continue doing what you did with the other brushes. Just make sure you paint with this brown color. Just here, like so. Maybe use a darker one. Like so. And maybe let's select another one, this one. And let's do the same. Change the size and maybe the angle a bit. And probably make it like so. And something like that. I will leave it like that. I will not continue doing anything else. And now to make the final adjustments, what I did is I used one of my actions because it looked really cool. I used my autumn tones action, so I'll select it and press the play key, and this will create this effect. You can also download this from my website, from the Photoshop actions section. This is the autumn tones action, so you can use it in Photoshop CC, Photoshop CS. It should work on previous versions of Photoshop. It just creates a bunch of adjustment layers, and here you have two layers if you need more light or something a bit darker. It depends on how you like it. So this is the final effect. Let me show you the original image again. Let's create a snapshot and another snapshot, and this is the result that we created, and this is the original image effect and original image. So I hope you liked this tutorial. It's a bit it's a very weird effect, but I don't know, I think it's interesting. And if you use Instagram, just tag your images with the hashtag psdbox.com, and they will appear on our website on the social wall. That's all for today. I'm Andrei from PSD Box, and see you on the next tutorial.